Okay, we'll call this meeting to order.
Business, finance, minutes. Had these minutes for about 3 weeks now, and we've had a motion.
Motion approved.
A motion and a second.
Second.
And a second. Any further discussion? All in favor, say aye.
Aye.
Opposed, no. Motion carries. Take care of the sales tax report, interest report, September and October, finance director's report. And I'll stop right there and send those to the commission. Look those over if you have any questions, especially about the finance director's report. Todd, entertain a motion. You get ready. Let me send to the commission. Have a motion here, second.
Second.
All in favor, say aye.
Aye.
Opposed, no. First quarter of 2016-17 finance report, court funds, highway funds, bill funds. Any questions? Todd, entertain a motion. Have a motion here, second.
Second.
Any further discussion? All in favor, say aye.
Aye.
Opposed, no. And we'll slow down a little bit. Litigation tax resolution.
Robert had contacted me. The judge's current salary is listed on page 26. It's right out of $150. And then he's got the collections from the fees from the litigation tax for the past 3 fiscal years. So currently, we're collecting $45 per criminal on the civil case. And he's wanting to know if we're interested in increasing that fee to help.
Let me say something. Judge Ferris, before I forget, he called me yesterday, and I think he complimented some of the others, and he was apologizing for not being here, but he had a full docket and said the things on the docket. He just couldn't be here. And he suggested $100 was cost, what he told me on the phone. So, pleasure of the committee or Robert, you know.
Mayor, though, yeah, Judge Ferris called me this morning and said Robert would be here to represent him this morning.
We discussed it a couple weeks ago and discussed it again yesterday, and might entertain the thought of just leaving it as it is for another year. We've discussed a few changes that possibly make to generate a little more revenue on that line. So I never like to increase the tax on anything. That's just a suggestion. He's fine with it either way.
How much would it have to increase to cover the salary cost? How much would we need to go up? I mean, not maybe to $100, but what would the increase that would actually cover be required? 15%, I think. So we need about $20,000 versus $45.
We can't increase it though that much, can we? We can only increase it by $6.
Yeah, the resolution I've got in here is the one that was previously passed.
Okay.
Information.
What you and Judge Ferris is saying is that we need to leave it at 45 for another year.
Yeah, and revisit it next year maybe. Yeah. But with that being said, it's reflecting about the same amount for the past 3 years. It's pretty close to the dollar, but maybe there's some improvement there. So we can,
At one time, is it because the salary has increased over time or because the intake has decreased?
I think Andrew can tell you more. That salary has increased, yeah.
Okay, so.
The judges is based on population and the court cases, and where most of the officials every 4 years, I think, is adjusted or whenever the state gets a raise, but his is pretty well adjusted anyway. Based on those numbers.
So we're not going to catch it up.
Maybe not. Yeah.
Luck is usually not a good point.
That's right.
But now the resolution that's in here has been amended, right? It's not the original. Because it does, under Section 1, say that it would be an increase by $14 in excess of the $45. So it's asking for the total to be 54. No.
What it is, each year in December, this resolution itself has to either be reenacted or it needs to be amended. And amended meaning it needs needs to, can be adjusted up to amount to cover the salary of the judge. So we have to run this through in December, either as it is to keep it as it is, or we need to amend it. So we reenact the current one, which will be a little bit less still than covering the judge's salary, or we amend it to make the difference.
So the $14 for the amendment would cover the salary, is that what I'm reading up here?
That's the old resolution. That's been approved, reenacted annually, I think the past 3 years.
Yeah. $45 is the current fee.
What is that?
The section one says that shall be increased by $14, in excess of the $45, so this has been amended already. Is that correct?
Down there further, it says it's got the 19th day of September.
Right, but read right below that, Philip, where that's in kind of highlighted, that $14. That's been added in, so is that a recommendation that's been made to increase it to that?
Not currently, this was what the resolution, the recommendation that was approved back in that, on that day.
So what are we charging?
$45.
Well, that says $45 plus $40.
$14 more, that's what I'm saying.
I don't understand, now I don't.
This wouldn't have been the original.
Robert, do you have any leads you're working on?
I don't know. Maybe it was revised, I pulled this out, I think I've just.
$45 is what we're collecting.
Yeah, $45 is.
Well, I read that back, when we brought up to $45, it's increased by $14 at that time, to bring it to $45.
$45, okay.
Because it's back to September of 2011, at that time, it was rate $14 to bring it to $45.
Yeah.
Okay.
And that's what we've been charging, Robert had $45 for the last few years. If you decide to amend it, the HIRW new resolution stating, you know, increase will be $10, bring it to excess of, I mean, to $55.
What is that, now there was something mentioned earlier about the $6, is that a maximum?
That's what I was just questioning. This resolution originated with Ben Lynch's office. Looking at the first two paragraphs, to me, it's saying we can't increase it more than $6.
Well, Judge Farris has recommended that we don't do anything for another year, I'm gonna make a motion if we don't do anything for another year.
Have a motion, a second, any further discussion, time to discuss.
Me, I don't think we got choice. We pay it out, pay it later. If the intake's been the same, receipt's been the same, and the salary keeps going up, I mean, it's simple, man, for it to be. So I think we ought to go ahead and raise it.
Any further discussion?
I think his concern too was just because of the increase in the fines, so on folks, I think, was his, that was his concern, was that the you know, would continue to put up more of a burden on people for speeding tickets or things of that nature, so, and in civil cases.
Well, I totally understand that, but if you, right now, the burden shifted to the taxpayer.
Yeah, I agree, you know, I hate to go with Robert, Judge Farris on this, but, you know, we're in a hole, right? And we got $6, what's $6? Most people don't speak things, don't pay it for this court anyway, I would think.
Well, if the way this reads, we can't increase more than six each year.
Right.
So we would do six this year.
Anyway, we have a motion, a second, any further discussion? All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Let's do a roll call.
Woodall.
Aye.
Feeny.
Aye.
Eldridge.
No.
Hold on, I'm trying to run. Feeny.
Aye.
No.
And Hughes.
No.
3-3. I don't know. First time I've ever had to pull this thing in 9 years.
I just don't need any speed tickets now.
You'll be the first one.
Be the first one to get one.
Yeah.
So someone don't make a motion.
$6 motion, we increase the fee by the $6.
Have a motion here, second.
Second.
Have a second. Any further discussion? All in favor, say aye.
Aye.
Opposed, no. Motion carries, thank you.
Brenda Clark, discuss pay rate issues in her department. Brenda?
Have y'all got copies of what you got here? Is it okay to have those there?
Do I need to go run make some?
I made copies, I just didn't know whether it was okay to do it or not.
Okay.
I'm here to talk about some pay raises in my office. I know that's a no-no subject, but I just lost a really good employee because she could find a job that paid more than what she was making. She had been there a year and was making $12.24. And what you're getting is a list of just court work employees to compare the salaries. And I've written, if I knew what year they started work, it's written up there. And if you'll notice that Tappy in my office has been there since 1982. And she's making less than people in circuit that have been there less time. And I think that we need to do something to adjust the payroll scheme. Happy, we took on probate and we did not hire another employee. And it's quite a bit of work, as Robert can tell you. We're doing more probate than we are in anything, and right now it's just Happy and I. And we're struggling with all the workload. And I need to find somebody, but the ones that have applied are not going to come for 1224 because they're already making more than that. Of course, I know Franklin County has really good benefits, but that doesn't compensate for the amount of work that we have in our office. And if you'll note, in one position in the General Sessions Judge's office, one has been there 11 months, and she makes $17.42 per hour. In his office, if someone leaves, they hire the new employee at what that person left at making. And I don't know, I think we've got to do something to set salary rates. Because I don't think it's fair for a new employee to start in at what the other person left at. I don't know how you feel about it. I've never done that. They're not experienced. And I don't think I'm going to be able to get somebody to work in my office for $12.24 an hour. And I would like to have a pay raise for at least that position there. And I don't know how to even figure. I mean, Roberts, his part-time people make $10.46 an hour. And I know nobody likes to talk about pay raises. But that's where I'm sitting today. And if you'll just look at some of the salaries, and I know that part of this was brought on by the lawsuit Nancy filed years ago for salary. And I know that's how a lot of that happened. But it still is leaving people in my office way behind. And we took probate. We didn't hire anybody else. We're doing it with what staff we've got. Basically, I don't have room. I have three desks, and we all work out front. There's an office I could use, but I'm right there every day helping with everything that we do. But that's my job. But I do think that I need a salary increase. I would love to see Cappy at least increase to what these people are making that have been there a lot less time.
The position that the person just left, that particular position in this office, we have experienced quite a bit of turnover. She's been through three people in not a very long amount of time. And that's probably other than the correctional officers and dispatch, that's the only other position where we've had issues at.
Do you have a recommendation for that new position, Ms. Giovanni?
Well, I don't think that they deserve $17.42 an hour starting out as they do in other offices. But if I had had it in my budget at that time, the girl would have stayed for $15 an hour. But she was offered $16 somewhere else, and I couldn't compete with $16, so I didn't even try. So I just had to let her go. I mean, I had to tell her, you can get $16, and I know I could have. So, and she was really good at hiding it. And now it had been, I was struggling just too long.
Any questions? Comments? On a December 1, we want to.
This is something we talked about last night, the Health and Welfare Committee meeting. And this is not, I think there's a bigger issue here than certainly you need an answer today, and I'm sure you'll get one, but we somehow, I think the Finance Committee and the commission have got to get the elected officials on the same page with the salary guidelines. And right here's a great example of what's happening. It's so uneven throughout the departments because no one's following the guidelines. And somehow we've got to get cooperation throughout the county to have a structured grade level and step level that people will abide by. Because this is exactly what's going to happen. The department's going to start robbing people from the department if this continues.
We might have nowhere to go but up. They would be coming down if they came to my office.
Well, but going from your office to somewhere else.
Yeah,
That's happened.
Yeah.
Yeah, wait a second.
And that shouldn't happen if the pay is equal or fair, at least. And I struggle with hiring somebody. When somebody leaves, you bring somebody in at that salary. I just don't see any logic to that whatsoever.
There is no logic to that, period.
Yeah.
If that person's got significant experience, there is no logic to that.
Exactly right. But that's a bigger topic.
If Andrew's done it, I'd say it's her. There's no logic to that. It is not good sound financial management for the taxpayer to do that.
Well, it's not good in business, period. That's not the way I run my business. When I lose a manager, I don't bring another manager in at that person's salary that's been there for 5 years. You just don't do that. But this is a subject we tackled when I was on the Finance Committee last year, and we said we'd have something in place by December to start following the guidelines. So I think it just shows the absolute need for getting all the elected officials together and come to a common ground on how we administered the program. So that's
a question I was asking for, Dave, when Commissioner wanted to speak. But we did say December 1st. How is that?
Well, as I recall, what December 1st was, there were employees that were below what the plan said they should have been at. And this was the first step, is to get those people. If we're going to follow the plan, then everybody should be where they're supposed to be in the plan. And that was the first step. And I don't know. I haven't talked to Andrea or Annette about that.
The money is budgeted.
Yeah. And she had worked through. She had worked through with the elected officials what pay level each person should be. And therefore, then they could find on the plan where they should be dollar-wise. I think she was still working some isolated situations, though. This was back a month or so ago. But that may or may not even address this situation, because these were just folks who were below where the plan say they should be.
Yeah, and her defense, I know the chamber's having the same issue at $12 an hour, finding an assistant. it's just almost impossible, especially with the workload I'm sure you're faced with, to get somebody to stay for $12 an hour. Now, the benefits do help in your case versus the chamber doesn't have any benefits, but it's, the labor force is getting tough, no doubt.
Brenda, this 12, 24, is that what the individual started at and they were still there a year later?
No, she got the percentage raise after 6 months. But that's where she was when she left. There's $12.50 budgeted, yeah.
That's the question I would ask, yeah.
I would pay $12.50.
So that position is $12 and a half position is what you're saying?
Well, and Brenda, not to throw a rock at you, but we don't know what we're voting on.
Yeah, I know.
You have a problem, but no proposed solution. That's okay, I understand.
Well, I'm just basing it on, so how many years some of Robert's employees, because I just got court personnel, because that's what I would think would be fair to compare it to. But if somebody can make $10.46 an hour, part-time, a full-time employee is much more valuable. And, you know, for me, part-time wouldn't work. But I'm thinking she would have stayed for $15. This is the last meeting.
So I was just asking, Andrew, if we meet on these commit in December, I couldn't have thought. What really should happen, I think, this is my opinion, is we have an immediate situation and we have a major, bigger problem that we're going to try to address somehow, okay? But what we really should do is let Annette look at that, those employees and those rates compared to other folks in the thing, and let her come up with a recommendation on what this person or that position, okay, should make. Now that means we wouldn't have that till January. I understand.
Yeah.
But
I mean, there's no way to have you. I can even take a day off.
No.
But you can't leave one person.
So what you're asking for is to.
I'd like something. I need help immediately.
To hire another person.
I really do.
And you're saying that the rate of that position is too low.
I think 12.24 is too low for what this person does.
All right. Is it already in your budget to have this other position?
Yes, but at 12.24 per hour.
At 12.50.
12.50 is the max.
Yeah.
So if we approve something higher than that, either you have to take it from some other place in your budget, or we have to do an amended budget. Mm-hmm. So the question is, can you absorb an increase in pay?
I think Andrew would know more about that than I would. I mean, I know I'd never go over budget unless it's some type of emergency.
Excuse me, can I say something else? Rather than make a mistake here on giving the wrong salary, why wouldn't we have Annette give a recommendation on what the counties around us, the other departments and all that, and that could be done fairly quickly, couldn't it?
Yeah, what we'd be doing is if we don't like to approve an unknown amount.
That's what
but
I'm
in
saying,
essence, yeah. We could approve an unknown amount right here. So it wouldn't last till go for January. I think we can.
Yes, you can.
But I'm trying to figure out whether we're approving a pay rate for a position or an amendment to the budget.
She might be able to make it. She's at 20%, 22% of her budget. But in all honesty, Brenda doesn't have much of a budget other than payroll. She doesn't use a lot of office supplies, so generally doesn't have equipment needs. She just had an overhaul on her system. Most of her budget is payroll and then data processing services.
How long has that person been gone from the position?
About 2 weeks.
By the time you hire somebody, you would have made up a difference.
Well, see, and my problem too is I'm in court. When we have court, I'm there. That leaves Taffy alone on that.
No, well, I understand. But what I'm saying is you're saving money in your budget right now.
Yeah, I've always been very frugal.
Well, you're saving because she's not on the payroll.
Well, that's true. That's true.
And then hiring someone new, there's going to be 6 months without retirement, which is
Let me make a motion that we let Annette derive the appropriate rate for that position, and that she be approved, but she's already approved to fill that position at this, at Annette's recommended rate, and that we defer any amendment to the budget to see how she, see if she can stay within budget.
As I recall, her budget was one of the best.
Yeah.
Was presented last year. Maybe you ought to up your budget next year.
I'm just saying that you're gaining ground with this person not being here.
Well, I'm gaining ground money-wise, but not work-wise.
Understand. So we approve Annette's determination of the position and defer a budget amendment to see how the budget.
Well, we probably should, we probably won't have to do a budget amendment. I mean, even, because you're going to say, we're not going to have to pay any retirement during this time, because they're not going to be eligible for retirement. As you say, the couple of 3 or 4 weeks or months salary that we're going to save, that's going back in there. So she'll probably be all right to budget time, provided that salary is within line of some of these others here.
Actually, I have a motion to say defer that decision to do the budget time. That could be what.
Okay, we have a motion. Do I hear a second?
I'll second the motion.
Have a second. Any further discussion? But what I'd like to say, Brenda, I know what you're going through, because you've got a 3-person office, and boy, it gets tough, you know, even in mine is not a court-attended office like yours is. But anyway, have a motion, second, no further discussion. All in favor, say aye.
Aye.
I want to thank you, but I have to go back. Happy Thursday. Thank you.
Opposed, no. Motion carries. County General Solid Waste Drug Control Fund Amendment Resolution 2930.
There are a couple of items within this budget I wanted to discuss. The first option is using some fund balance. That's the only one on this amendment that is using fund balance. We had a situation where we had an employee off on leave, and they've come back. And in working with the mayor and with Christine Hopkins and Ron Bailey to help resolve the situation, we're wanting this person to work half-time in Christine's office and half-time in the drug court office to help those two departments. There is currently no payroll in those departments other than the drug court supervisor, I think is what it's called.
Yeah, and I think I need to strike that right now from this.
So you want to remove this from the?
Yes, you just don't. We're not going to bring this up this time.
What are we striking here?
The first section.
The first block.
Of the amendment.
Okay.
If the time does come, I'll speak to one individual about this commission also.
So the rest of these items, Andrea, I assume are just corrections?
The next three are donations, the past three money that needs to be budgeted. There is one on the bottom that Scott wanted to talk to you guys about. He's on the very bottom of the first page. He wanted to restructure his office. He can do that within his current budget this year. Next year, he may have to request a little more money to do that, and he can talk about that. He's made a change in his staff.
Good morning. I'd like to bring forth a correction or a reclassification of the job position. As you know, I've been in office for about 6 months. I've looked at a lot of policies and procedures. I've cut a few things and done a few things differently, trying to save money, trying to manage the department a little bit better. I've looked at my staff that I have, and I had an administrative assistant. The more I looked at that, the office could be a lot more effective if I had a person who would be called a deputy director and change the classification to a person who could, I guess, multitask more. Go out in the field during emergencies. If I can't take care of a project, send them on the project. and do different things. And I also like them to be able to do a little administrative work as well, act as a project manager. A lot of you are familiar with a project manager. And that's the type of person I think that would help the county and the agency progress further. I can do it within my budget this year, but it would be a pay increase for next year's budget because I've saved some money. As they said before, I haven't had any retirement benefits or this new person won't either for the year. So I think within, I can do it within my budget and I can postpone it to do it within my budget. But next year, it would probably be a budget increase. The area that I'm looking at, and I don't want to be real specific because you know, you guys will make the decision, but I would kind of like to keep the salary at a level of a deputy, a sheriff's department deputy. And that's similar to the person I'm looking for. It's someone who has those type of capabilities. But that's the area on payroll that I would be looking at as far as the increase goes.
But it won't be a real big increase.
No, it won't be a huge one.
$3,000 a year. So you have a person in the administrative assistant role now?
No.
You have no person at all?
No, I had to make a change in that position, and I did not see the value in putting back a purely administrative person because I'm taking care of that anyway, and I'm capable of taking care of
it. Right now, you have an opening.
Correct.
And you want to reclassify that opening from administrative assistant?
Yes, sir. Yes,
to
sir.
A deputy director?
To it, yes, sir.
Okay.
Let me say this, Scott, it sets in 6 months to save the county about $11,000. I've been tracking, you know, pretty well. And like you say, this position he had is gone. And that's what he's doing. Scott's doing a good job. I hope y'all.
I don't think it would be efficient for me to fill it back in that title.
Oh, I understand. And so you're not looking at adding that position back?
No, sir. I'm going to change direction. I take that work. I was taking it pretty much anyway. A couple phone calls a day and a quarterly report and a few other odds and ends was, you know, I can't do that. But I am, I'm not progressing as far as the safety aspects. Doing a safety director position and doing inspections. I need to be out doing those things. And I need some, you know, help physically, you know, doing.
Okay.
That's all I ask.
Okay, thank you.
And the rest is just clean up.
Motion approved with the change. Okay. By the mayor.
Second. Have a motion and second. Any further discussion? All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed, no. Motion carried.
Next is the library amendment. I'm sorry. This is an amendment to take care of the December 1st requirement on salary positions.
Is that still going into effect? There was some talk about it being deferred.
The library board wanted to go ahead and put it into effect.
It hadn't been deferred.
So we're given some.
They talked about it, but
I don't think so. I don't think it was deferred.
So we're giving some individuals an increase.
Just the salary director.
Well, it looks like part-time employees are getting increases too.
They're increasing the hours of their part-time.
Why?
Well, they feel a need to.
Well, that has nothing to do with the December 1st.
You know, they've gone part of the year at not full staff, so they're going to go over on their part-time hours anyway when you look at the percentages. Some of their part-time, actually they've had a part-time that's had to work full-time temporarily due to the staff that have not worked.
But. You're doing good, Andrew. You're trying, but it's not holding water. Why the part-time employees' hours are going up is if they've had trouble getting people, that don't make sense.
Well, they could have moved money from one of the other line items, from the full-time line items to take care of it.
Why didn't they?
Well, the whole idea of the December 1st thing, if you have an employee who works, more than the 40 hours a week, you have to pay them overtime. If their salary is less than that new limit.
And that's.
So the answer is either no overtime or increase their pay rate. So what I'm hearing, we're increasing the pay rate, but we're also increasing the part-time hours, which could be, that doesn't make sense to me.
Well, the $2,280 is for the salary position, bring it to that minimum rate of pay.
But is the supervisor director working more than 40 hours?
In all honesty, I couldn't tell.
I mean, if they're not working more than 40 hours, there shouldn't be a reason for an increase. The increase is on the salary if that salary just changed back to hourly rate.
I'm just guessing. I don't know a salaried person that's only working 40 hours in the county.
That may not be. I don't know. That was just a question I was asking.
I have trouble supporting it with those two questions in my mind. What are the extra hours for? And with the increase in pay, is the individual going to continue to work extra hours or not?
You find that out?
I'm just saying I'm going to vote no, but I don't understand. It may still pass. Just me.
Okay, let me get a motion, if there is a motion. I can entertain a motion. Entertain a motion. Okay, it fails because of lack of a motion. Highway fund amendment.
This is for state aid increase and for insurance, or from sale of refurbished equipment, I guess. Just budgeting that state aid project, which is down on Buncombe Road.
That's a good thing.
Yeah.
You know, we'd like to say too, this next year, the bridge grant for state aid is still going to be at 98.2. And we are working with the legislators right now to get the state aid road to stay at 98.2. So hopefully that does lift big savings to us.
So of that $590,000, $11,803, which a portion of that is in kind for signage and that type thing. But in order to accounting,
Motion to approve.
Have a motion.
Second.
Have a second. Any further discussion? All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed, no. Motion carries. County Department's time sheet changes 21-20. So many times in and out for ACA.
This is a change that I want to propose, and I had a copy of this in the meeting last month, and we got in a hurry at the end. In order for us to actually account for the ACA regulations, beginning the December 1, I'd like to put an in and out time on the timesheet. Some already do that. Most departments have gone to a timekeeping system, which takes care of that. That being the case, they wouldn't use this. But in order for us to actually keep up with, just in all honesty, like the judicial commissioners, instead of just putting one day, we don't really know the hours that they're working. And in order for us to meet those federal guidelines, we need to change our timesheet. So basically what we're doing is adding an in time and an out time so that we can calculate that on an annual basis.
Who fills out the timesheet?
Who fills out the
timesheet? Yeah, who fills it out?
The employee.
Okay.
And then the supervisor signs off on it.
Of course, go with the time clock, this won't be necessary.
Right. And I'm working on that RFP, but I have several on.
I was going to say, the ones over the time clock, it's going to fail.
Yeah, it's not. There are several, most departments, well, not most, but a good majority of them are on a timekeeping system, so this would not affect them, just the departments that don't utilize a time clock.
Do we need a motion?
I
Yes.
Motion approved.
Have a motion?
Second.
Second, any further discussion? All in favor, say aye.
Aye.
Opposed, no. Motion carried. Recommendation, judicial commissioner salary dilemma.
We've been talking about this for a little bit. I've done a little bit of figuring. Basically, right now, what the judicial commissioners do is, you know, they write one day, and they work 2 to 3 days a week, the full-time commissioners do. And then the part-time work on an as-needed basis, there are 3 part-time, and they also work 24-hour. There's no stipulation of on-call time or actually at the jail facility working. We have them as full-time salaried positions paying full-time benefits. In looking at the, if they say they're working 24 hours, when you break it all down, basically either we need to come up with about $24,000 for each full-time salaried position to meet that regulation on the salaried personnel, or come up with a schedule for them and an hourly rate. Now, on page 36, I've got kind of a mock schedule, which could be adopted, I mean, it could be changed, I guess, as they see fit. They've got 3 full-times, they've got 3 part-times. But basically, with this type of schedule, the full-time would work 40 hours a week. They'd go on 8-hour shifts. Or if they wanted to, they could work a 16-hour shift, as long as they didn't go over 40 hours within a week. I think it can be done, especially since they have that added that 3rd part-timer this past year. On page 35, calculated per pay period, the amount of hours that they've worked. And you can see some of them vary a little bit. You know, if somebody's out, somebody else is going to pick up, that type thing. But when you break it down, if you looked at it on a 24-hour rate, down at the bottom is basically what their hourly equivalent would be. Now, I realize they're not there all the time. You know, I think some of them may go in and stay at the jail and just be on hand. Some may just be called in. But I feel like that going on an hourly rate, and my suggested rate for them would be $12. That's a suggested rate. In all the other counties that we've talked to, everybody does it different. Some of them have them just on the clock working 40 hours a week. Some have attorneys that they hire. But this is the most feasible way that I felt that we're being most conscious of the taxpayers of Franklin County to go at it in this way. The new budget need for the gross salary would be $17,541, but that would be for all the employees. Where this is my suggestion.
So they would all be paid the $12 rate?
Mm-hmm. It wouldn't go over 40 hours.
That,
if they stay within this, they got here.
And I realize sometimes they may not be able to. They may have, you know, somebody may be sick and somebody may be on vacation, that type thing. You may have a part-timer that goes into overtime hours or one of the full-time. But I think this is the most feasible way to solve the situation. And I felt like if I came up with a suggested schedule, something that, you know, the judge and the judicial commissioners, we could all sit down and look at to say this would be possible or not. And there's room, like I said, to move around, you know, the shifts or the hours. But I kind of feel like they like the consistency of having the same schedule all the time. So
I'd kind of like to see that, you know, maybe we make a recommendation, this is what your recommendation would be, and then give with the judges, commissioner, judicial commissioners. It's in Judge Parrish, give you a leeway on this.
Yeah, you certainly entertain that schedule. And you, as you said, you would like to meet with Andrew Thursday, Friday.
Okay. And and then it still comes information, so you have opportunity, information, have opportunity there, yes or no.
Okay, so what do we need to do?
So we want to send this, we want to make a motion to send this to the commission with Andrea's recommendation after she talks to the judge? Is that what you're saying?
Well, you can make a recommendation, you can make the motion, send it to the commission, and not after you talk to the judge, just talk to the judge, and if he has anything he wants to change or anything like that, the night of the commission meeting, we can make that change if there are any, if the commission sees fit to do that.
Is there any cost associated with benefit increase, or is it just salary?
Yes, there would be on the social security and retirement.
Do we know what that would be total?
I'm looking at the 20%.
So 17,000 plus the 20%.
Okay, I can, it's a good motion.
Commissioner Clark made a motion.
Well, well, my question was really, was what kind of motion did he want? That was my question. You want to make, so if, what we're thinking is sending this to the commission as it is, and if Judge Farris wants to make a change, we'll make a change that night.
Yes, we do.
I'll make that an informal motion.
Second?
Yeah.
The motion is second.
Second?
Now, any further discussion? All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed, no. Motion carries. Current time clock guidelines, page 36.
This other was in last month's too. I was hoping that you looked over it a little bit. One thing with the time clock, which we haven't gone to the new system, but most of the time clocks everybody using is the same time clock. Different department heads have different rules. Some may have their employees clock out for lunch, some may not. Some employees, they may have them clock out for break, some may not. And this is just a general guideline that basically states that, you know, we'll follow the department head's discretion, but we want to get the department head to give a list of the written rules to us at finance so that when we're looking at timesheets, we have a verbal on it, you know, but she knows, Heather knows how Robert wants to handle it, knows how Philip wants to handle it, but it'd be nice if we had something on paper. So if an employee had a question, we could, you know, show to them, this is why we figure your time this way. We've already got that for highway. We've had that for a good while, and we've got it for the sheriff's department as well, that address how they handle holidays on the time clock or administration time on the time clock, that kind of thing. But this is just a general time clock policy that basically it just talks about the Fair Labor Standards Act. Just outline it about the overtime and the department head policies. I kind of like to call it rubber stamp that form.
Motion to rubber stamp.
Have a motion to rubber stamp here. Second, there's a second. Any further discussion?
Could I make a comment on the
discussion?
It seems to me that we definitely do need a time clock policy because from my experience in business, anyway, it may be different in government, that if you have an employee that's not clocking in and out for breaks, then when they decide to quit their job mad, they're going to come back and sue you for all those breaks. And that has happened, trust me, many times. And I would think that the elected officials would want to abide by a policy that protected the citizens of our county from lawsuits. So I would suggest that we have a very definite time clock policy, because if not, one of these days we're going to be sued and have to pay a lot of breaks and lunches and all those things that they say they didn't get and they have gotten.
Well, Dave, it's kind of hard for us to do that because we are out. If I hadn't clocked,
well, if you have the proper time and attendance, you can do it from the field.
Well, what we do with ours is at the end of the week, when they get done doing that, each employee has to sign that saying that they've taken
that. So that's your cover.
But it's not going to show up on that time clock sheet is where they clock in and out, because there's no way. If I pulled everybody in at break time and send them back out on the job and pull them back in at lunch and send them back out on the job.
Yeah, well, I think there's remote possibilities, yeah. But that's something.
When we get the new system, that we'd be able to do.
That's what I'm suggesting. When you have a new system, I would recommend you have a very, very clear and concise policy for locking in and out.
Any further discussion? All in favor, say aye. Opposed, no. Motion carries. Resolution, State of Tennessee, deferred work, deferred compensation, 401K5457B, claims agreement, 38376.
I've gotten with the state on this, and they are telling me, Mike Garland is telling me, that it is fine for us to have some employees on the nationwide and some on the state plan. It does open up that liability. We had talked, you know, about, we probably have a couple of people that are really close to retirement that might not want to change plans, and he said that that was perfectly fine. We did not have to force them to go on the state plan.
Well, you know, real quickly, and that's fine. One of the advantages to us as a county government for moving to the state plan is that we no longer had that fiduciary responsibility of managing that nationwide plan. So if one person stays in it, we still have that fiduciary responsibility. Now, over time, it'll empty out. Okay, so it's still a good move for the employees, and if it's a good move for the employees without additional cost to us, it's a good move for us. So I can support it with that understanding that the employees can elect us to grandfather and stay in the nationwide. So I make a motion we approve that.
Have a motion.
Second.
Have a second. Any further discussion?
Now, the new employees will have that option though, right?
Good point.
The new employees will not have that option.
This is grandfathered only.
Right, that's what I thought. Right. We'll make that point.
Any further discussion? All in favor, say aye.
Aye.
Opposed, no. Motion carries. Register dates, new job descriptions, determine review process.
Skip at the grant summary.
I'm sorry, grant summary application, South Central Tennessee Development District, CDBG funds, grant $500,000, Deckard Water.
It's just in and out.
Motion approved.
Have a motion. Second. Any further discussion? All in favor, say aye.
Aye.
Opposed, no. Motion carries. Travis, sorry about the numbers, I'm trying to get through. Register dates.
I don't have a handout on this. Lydia is here. Since we've met last, she has, past couple of weeks, has gotten new job descriptions for her staff. In our meeting with Ben and the commissioners, we had requested that and agreed to review those. I guess I want to see if the finance committee wants to review these as a whole. It's been requested that more parties are involved in this process than what has been in the past.
I have a question about that.
Lydia.
What parties does she want involved in?
Well, she just wants more people involved in the classification of it other than one person.
Well, we're paying that one person taxpayer dollars. I think that one person is capable of doing that. That's my favorite.
Well,
and we direct them to do it.
The process, yeah, there's not been a standard process, but what the process really should be is Annette should look at these and have a recommendation for some approval authority. Now, that approval authority in the past has been the finance committee by definition, and it can stay the finance committee. Or it can be the Health Insurance Retirement Welfare Committee. But in the past, it's been this committee that's approved because it is an addition of cost. But I would like to have her recommendation, her review and recommendation before we consider that. She's in the best position to make that comparison.
That's her job.
Can I hand out something?
Well, you know, I think too we need to, you know, make sure her attorney and our attorney has this too before we discuss it too much. Because we was directing that meeting. You know,
exactly. We have a different angle on this one than we would in the normal process.
Right.
What I describe as the normal process. But from the two attorneys' point of view, what are we being asked to do? What are we reviewing?
Mr. Peters asked in that meeting, Andrew, correct me if I'm wrong, to bring that to him, right?
No.
To us?
Yes.
Okay, I stand to be corrected then.
We asked that Lydia would prepare new job descriptions if there have been that many changes in her office and provide those new job descriptions. And in the meeting, it was requested that a committee of some sort classify within those guidelines.
Well, I'm like Commissioner Eldridge on that. The recommendation should come from Anaya and then come to either to this committee. Is that not right?
That's the way we do all of them.
Yeah, I mean, I don't know what committee that you're talking about.
This is different. That is the normal process, and this one's just different because of the circumstances. But we have to keep in mind, there's obviously some concern. I don't want to know what it is necessarily, that of having Annette make this determination. Okay, I don't understand that. I don't know it. I don't care. But she still needs to be a part because she understands the comparison across departments better than any of us do. So I would still say she needs to review it. It's just like the budget. The commission approves the budget annually. This committee makes a recommendation. She makes a recommendation, we approve. I still think she ought to get a chance to review it before now. Do we have all of us review it or some small subset?
Well, I think, this is my opinion, I think Annette should review it first and bring it before this committee.
Yeah. Or some subset of this, if that's what we choose, but it's been this committee. Now, that would push it till January. Or some special call meeting.
Yeah, but I don't think we have the input. I don't think we can do anything today.
No, I'm just saying by definition.
Yeah, I think it's got to go to do Annette first.
What I handed you out is, I've never felt like the game salary actually put my employees where they belong. I've redone my job descriptions 3 or 4 times. Recently with the internal controls, that's revamped the way the office works. Everyone was cross-trained, everybody could do every job, but the state now, you can't do that. Everybody has to have a certain title. My two chief deputy and second deputy, they keep the books. And then, you know, all the job descriptions are varied across the board. I've got copies that I handed you to show you that other employees with the county that have been here far longer than my employees, what they make. And I also have what my employees make. That's what I'm just asking to be fair. Annette's fine, but with the gang study, it doesn't even put my employees, even with the amount that y'all had in December, doesn't even put my employees even where they should be now without the revised job descriptions. They're way below.
And is that because of the grade level we didn't know, or?
The grade level, and they haven't stepped up. And where other employees are hired making more than mine, they come in off the street making more than mine when I've got, you know, 27-year employee, 18-year, two 18-year employees.
But I guess my question is, their grade level is higher that you've, or somebody has promoted them to over time. Is that the issue?
I guess so. I really don't know how everything in the salaries are just completely out of order in all the offices, in my opinion. But yeah, I'm glad with Annette looking over those and giving suggestions, and since I've given new job descriptions. But I'm just asking you all to compare this and get the grid of the salaries and look at my employees and their years and their job descriptions as opposed to what other employees are making. I just feel like mine are being done unfair.
Well, when a system is not followed well,
yes,
universally, then you end up that you have situations like this, and it reminds me of my daughter when she was 17 coming in and saying, well, I want to stay out till 11:30. instead of 11. I said, well, why? Because everybody gets to spend out the 11.30. Well, who? Well, just everybody. Well, we end up comparing the highest over here to the this person. Everybody wants to compare to the highest and therefore move everybody up when there's no stability. So we just got to work this out to where we've got some consistency in here. So I make a motion we let Annette review this and bring her recommendation back to the finance.
Have a motion. And a second.
A second.
Second. Any further discussion? All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Motion carries.
This is not going to affect their lawsuit. This is what they requested.
This is what they requested. All the Little Gibson Services LLC judge jail estimate approval. Read next step.
Page 78's got the estimate from OLG on the cost. So basically, we're at the point where we're looking at funding. And we're looking at the next step of doing an RFP construction management, which will handle the bid process.
So what are you doing? What are we looking at?
Approve the next thing. What's the next thing?
Funding.
Funding here.
Now that we have estimated cost of the
this is the architect engineers, and this is what the estimated cost is. And the next step we need to approve the passing on the commission that we approve going to that step and being bid out the RFP for construction manager, and also the next step will be in line is to bid the project. So this is sent to the commission to say yes, we've got to issue a bond, you know, to take care of this, blah blah blah.
Did this come through the law enforcement committee?
It's come through our special committee that we have the county correction partnership committee. Okay, so they're the ones that's handling this.
Yes. Well, I'd make sure it's come through the right channel.
Yeah. The bond issue for the jail is paid in the past.
It's done.
You know, we're free. Clean and true. I don't see we have any other choice to go through and do what we need to do because of the overcrowding issue. We've been working with the state.
Well, we knew that. Yeah. Yeah. We knew that, 3 years ago when we started this correction partnership committee, that we would come to this.
Yeah.
And we were, you know, we were fortunate that we could wait until the bonds were rescinded on the jail. So we were fortunate there.
So we're just making a motion to send this to the commission. No one's coming to get you to your face. Motion to forward to the commission.
Have a motion here, second.
The
have a motion to hear a second.
Oh, he second.
Oh, I thought Johnny second.
Any further discussion? Any further discussion, Andrew?
No.
All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed, no. Motion carried. Budget. Calendar, page 798.
No difference. Gets it done by motion to approve it and the finance committee meeting schedule, which is the same.
Motion and a second. Please budget calendar, 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 calendar. Any further discussion? All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed, no. Motion carries. Finance director, you got anything else or anything else on the agenda?
I do have a resolution that, I'm trying to come up with his name. Jeff Farmer, the district public defender, is going around to the counties and he's requesting that a fee be added on, $12.50 charge be added on for collections for the purpose of deferring the cost of legal representation and support services provided by indigent defendants in criminal proceedings from the 12th Judicial District. So basically, this is a resolution that they're requesting where we add on a fee to be collected and to be
turned over to the public defender's office.
Who's replacing this?
Jeff Foreman of the public defender's office. I just got this email yesterday.
I mean, is this to offset the cost of the public defender's office?
It's a hired investigator. I spoke with him. He actually sent us all an email, but I called him and he said it was, his office currently doesn't have an investigator. He's a public defender. So when he defends somebody that doesn't have money to defend themselves, he has to do the investigating himself. Is that correct?
That's correct.
So he's asking for this fee, which will actually go to the state and then distributed back to him. And it's kept in the county that collects it. That's the way it's described to be anyway.
The judicial district.
Yeah, judicial district, yeah, sorry. So he can have an investigator.
He actually had called and requested to speak to the commission at the next commission meeting and present the resolution. But I told him that any resolution has to go before a legislative committee at first. And then when he sent me the resolution, I realized. And he was on the agenda for Thursday night's legislative. He was going to show up and appear. And I looked at it yesterday and realized it's a money issue. So I contacted Andrew and told her, you know, do we need to go ahead and run it through finance this morning? So he doesn't even know that, you know, we've already discussed it. So, you know, you can go ahead and discuss it today, or I can contact him and we can keep it on legislative for Thursday night. And he was planning on attending then. But either way, if it's approved, he'll be at the commission meeting as well to answer any questions.
What's the will of the committee?
Oh, I need to understand more of what.
I don't know that I have all the answers. Just one thing though, it sounded to me, and I don't really have an opinion until I hear him, but it sounded like it would level the playing field a little bit for a defendant versus the prosecution. Prosecution has two investigators. Probably defender has zero. So if I went before court with a public defender, knowing I had zero investigators, it doesn't seem like a level playing field to me in the court system, but that's just my personal opinion. That's the way it was explained. So.
Just don't hold up about it.
Just want to pass it on the legislation. Commission.
Yeah, we send the legislative committee in. So what you're saying, pass it on to the issues.
And a motion.
I move that we send it there.
Have a motion, second.
Second.
Any further discussion?
Because he said he would be there, right?
Right.
Okay. So we get some discussion there.
All in favor say aye. No. Motion carries. Anything else? Move to adjourn.
So move.
Second.
Second.